In this video, we'll dive into how you, as a company, map your supply chain. Supply chain mapping is an essential step for a company to be in compliance with the EU Timber Regulation, also known as the EUTR. The regulation requires your company to determine the country of harvest for all the wood and wood products that you source. You shall use this information to analyze the risks of illegally harvested timber entering your supply chain. So what are the key steps for me to map my supply chains? First, you need to identify all your products covered by the EUTR and all their components. Two, for each component, you'll need to list all the commercial entities involved. Get started by placing your own company on the map, then your direct suppliers, then work your way backwards through your supply chain towards the original source of the wood products you are sourcing. Your supply chain map should at least go as far back as the country of harvest. Identify the location of each entity, as well as their nature of business. Examples of their nature of business could be manufacturer, paper mill, or forest management unit. It is recommended to map your supply chain all the way to the forest of harvest. 3. Depending on the level of risks in your supply chain, it may be required to identify all forest management units supplying timber for your products. For instance, if you need to validate a harvest permit to confirm that the timber was legally harvested, you will need to first identify the forest of origin for that timber. Composite products can be particularly difficult to trace. It might only be possible to draw a clear supply chain map up to the first processing mill. In this case, you may ask the mill to elaborate a wood fiber or wood pulp profile, which will provide important information to understand where the timber in the product is coming from. 4. Adding supporting documents to your supply chain mapping process will increase confidence in your supply chain map. This can be documents that prove a commercial relationship between two parties in your supply chain. Examples of documentation could be invoices, delivery notes, supplier contracts, purchase orders, and shipping documents, such as a bill of lading and insurance certificates. Collecting these documents will also help verify product descriptions, timber species used in the sourced products, volumes purchased, and potential certification claims made by your supplier. Another aspect worth considering when analyzing your supply chain map are the potential gaps where unidentified material might enter. The risk of mixing with an unknown or illegal material would undermine your risk assessment's validity, and you would risk non-compliance with the EUTR. The importance of systematically collecting and recording information cannot be overstated, but the process does not require exceptional measures. A simple supply chain map can be created in an Excel spreadsheet, or you may use other software to help better visualizing it. Communication with your suppliers is crucial to building and maintaining your supply chain map. If your suppliers make any changes in their sourcing, they must inform you so that you may adjust your risk assessment accordingly. Any new product that contains wood should be properly identified and risk assessed before being placed on the EU market. Your company should consider providing the necessary support to your suppliers if they are not aware of the EUTR and its requirements. Go check out EUTR.info.